Automatica is here again at last, with AI, robotics, and intelligent automation. In Munich, for the first time since 2018, you can experience what the production of the future is going to be like.
Automatica
is like one big class reunion, finally seeing colleagues, partners and customers again. Thank God Automatica's back. We've really been looking forward to Automatica, of course. When you have products that need to be explained, what's missing is direct contact with the customer. I can't sell machines like this with a piece of paper. The whole robotics industry has been booming, especially during COVID, so the timing of this trade show is perfect. Around 600 exhibitors are presenting innovative approaches, new technologies and intelligent systems. Plus, there are forums with the top minds in the industry and the latest and most exciting trends. The step from automated to autonomous production can be experienced live, right here at Automatica. Let's move on to the daily highlights from day one. Right in the entrance area, the 6-meter-high Sinar Tower welcomes visitors. Universal robots and robo-mines demonstrate their smart picking system that helps to automate intralogistics. Up to 250 crates can be stored at a height of 6 meters, saving a good 200 square meters of storage space. What's special here is that we have a robot that's collaborative and an AI-supported camera system. So component learning is no longer needed. I just chuck whatever I like into the box and the AI will find a way to pick it. Robotic giant KUKA is presenting its new cobots. Ease of use is the motto here. Thanks to the new operating system IQ Car OS, even people unused to robots can start one up right away. Everything is absolutely safe. The robot has multi-component sensors in each axis, so it can sense whether a human is nearby or stop if a collision has occurred. It's basically designed so that nothing happens to the human, so that makes interaction possible. Digital transformation is one of the key trends at Automatica. Festo is taking it to an entirely new level with new software in production. The plus point here is that the entire manufacturing process is optimized in terms of quality, maintenance, and energy efficiency. Predictive maintenance allows us to monitor the health of individual components, subsystems, or even entire plants during the machine's runtime. We can also see this here in the demonstrator. If we induce a fault here, it could be increased friction, for example, caused by low lubrication, wear or contamination on the component, then we see right away how this health score, as we call it here in Festo AX, goes down and automatically generates a maintenance message. And what's so exciting is that the machine is still running. It's continuing to run normally, but we already have the possibility to schedule a standstill in advance.
Aber wir haben eben schon im Voraus die Möglichkeit, einen Stillstand einzuplanen.
In the test zone at Automatica, visitors can experience the future at first hand. Everyone's invited to test out cobots and the like for themselves. Hands-on participation is expressly encouraged here. Beckhoff is presenting its own robot at Automatica for the first time. The special feature here is the robot's modular design. The focus is on what customers really need. The customer's free to choose. What's important, you see, is that the modules contain an endless rotation, and the whole transfer of power, data, fluids, vacuum happens in the module itself, even though it's endlessly rotating. So, you put customers in a position where they don't ask us what robot we can offer. Instead, we tell them precisely the kind of robot they need for their application, because it can be freely designed. As you can see in the background, we can easily generate single-axis systems and 2, 3, 4, up to 14-axis systems. That gives customers full freedom and variety to assemble their robots in line with applications and workspace. And that brings us to our daily talents. We present the winners of the Robothon as part of Munich Eye. First place and €10,000 go to the Curry team. For 4 weeks, the scientists worked on a solution for recycling electronic waste using AI and robotics. So those were the highlights from day one. We'll see you tomorrow and finish with today's Daily Vision from Melanie Wise.
So when we look into the future with robots and people working together, it's really about collaboration and making sure that that collaboration is seamless, that people feel comfortable with the robots, that they feel enabled and supported by those robots and not frustrated. And so a lot of the work that we're doing today in robotics is around making that interaction frictionless and seamless.